EWI building is located on the Technical University at Delft's campus, slightly south of downtown Delft. It's a large building topped by a high rise that measures 90 meters high. With that, it's the second tallest building in Delft and forms the icon for the TU. The building is composed of two rectangular volumes, offset slightly from each other, one's conveniently painted blue and the other red. The blue volume faces northeast, while the red volume faces southwest, catching most of the wind and solar radiation. Each volume has its own climate system. A geothermal heat exchange system, a cold and watt hotter source situated 80 meters below the building, helps precondition the ventilation air to a temperature of 21 degrees Celsius all year round. This air is directed to air handling units, situated on every third floor in each of the high-rise volumes. From there, it's distributed along the facade to the offices. In each office, an induction unit can warm or cool the ventilation air by 3 degrees and can be manually controlled by a thermostat. There's a double corridor facade on the long side of the building. It houses the sun shading system to keep out the radiation, and in summer there are vents in the facade that are open so that the hot air can ventilate. In winter, those vents are closed, and it functions as an insulation buffer only. One of the main climate problems AWI has is thermal bridges. They're located on the single facades, where the volumes are offset. Here, the thermal bridges are formed by steel columns that are in direct contact with window frames, without proper insulation. Another problem is horizontal leakage caused by high wind pressures on the same single facades. Perhaps the biggest complaint from users of the building is the lack of operable windows in the facade. High winds around the building are also a problem, velocity sometimes being so high, passing people get knocked off their bikes. These climate problems amount to AWI having a very large energy usage, almost 3 times as high as the average TU Delft faculty. Earth, wind, and fire is a natural air conditioning system that consists of 3 components. The first is the climate cascade. This works by pushing wind into a shaft and conditioning it with a shower of fine water droplets from the geothermal water source. The conditioned ventilation air then gets distributed into the building. The stale air gets sucked out by a second component, the solar chimney. Located on the south side of a building, the sun hits the chimney and warms up the air inside, which then rises, creating suction. The third component, the ventic roof, is a structure using the Venturi system, which uses negative pressure to create more suction for the solar chimney, in case the sun doesn't shine. Now the question is, how can we integrate this innovative system in AWI? Some features of AWI make integration a breeze, like the geothermal heat exchange system that can be hooked up to the climate cascade, high wind velocities that will combine great with a Ventec roof, and plenty of sun exposure to activate a thermal chimney. Keeping the requirements for each element in mind, there are several placement options. The climate cascade has many options, since it does not need to be oriented in a certain way, nor in contact with the sun or wind. It can be outside the building, integrated into the facade, or inside the building, perhaps in one of the existing shafts. The solar chimney has to catch as much sun as possible, so it should be oriented south. It can be realized in 3 different ways. Outside of the building, integrated into the facade, like a solar facade, or placed up against the building. The Ventec roof, of course, needs to be on the roof, but it has some options as well. It can sit on top of the roof and cover the entire building span, or just a small part, or be integrated into the skin of the building.